Danny, you were talking about being bummed earlier. That was in reference to the TRT thing, correct?
Yeah.
What, does that change your mindset at all? That's twice now you guys have improved. Or what did you guys didn't improve on? You approved Silva's. The Milwaukee Commission approved.
So here's what happened. So I told you, we test the shit out of these guys that are doing TRT. We gave him his last test, right? The week of the fight. He was perfect. He took another shot. Just put him over.
So it's nothing about the process. It was a personal mistake on his
part. And what does that extra shot really do for you? What did it really do for you the week of the fight? It destroyed everything. You didn't. Now you don't get the win money that we were giving. We were giving both guys show and win money, and you won the bonus. Now you lost both your win money and your bonus money. Ouch. So all of you guys out there that are on TRT, and it's legal, you want to fuck around and take that shot after you've been tested, there's the consequences. The consequences could not be worse. Now you're on suspension for a year. You lost your win and your bonus money, and I'm sure your sponsors aren't thrilled either.
Well, you had the situation with Rothwell too, when he says that he felt he did it all correctly under the commission, and somehow it happened. I mean,
I don't care. You're a grown man. You know. What's going on, dude.
Wait, are you getting any indication from fighters that are on that exemption that whether or not they think it's any help to them at all, that maybe all this is not worth it?
But here's what it does. Where it really helps you is during your training.
Right.
While you're training, it helps you heal faster and all this other stuff. Taking that extra shot the week of the fight just puts your levels up through the roof and doesn't really give you any extra, you know. If he didn't take that shot, they would have had the same fight probably. It's just not worth the risk. Why risk it? Now you see the consequences.
So, do you think that any of the fighters are coming around to that idea, though, that maybe this just isn't worth it?
If you have a quarter of a brain, it should.
So when you tested him, was he low? Because he was talking about him being low.
No.
So based on your feelings on it, is there any kind of inkling to say, all right, just ban it then, just get rid of it completely? That even with the situations that have come up, you still don't
lean towards that? We're always going to do what the Athletic Commission does. We're always going to go with the Athletic Commission. Listen, do you think it's great for me that this guy, I told you guys how much I love that fight and how into that fight I was, and it's just like, now it ruins it for me. You know, I talked to Mark Hunt, and Mark Hunt's like, let me tell you what, brother, I don't care what he was on or what he did, two guys went in there and did their thing, and you know, he actually defended him and was like, that dude went toe-to-toe with me and we put on something that, you know, was... It was pretty cool. You know, actually, Mark Hunt got me in a better mood about it, you know? But still,
you're not going to be sporting the shirt again?
The way you know, legally, you know.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Nothing.
So rumor has it that Brock Lesnar's coming for 168. Is he coming for the fight or is he coming to talk business?
Really? I don't know. I honestly don't know.